Hey everybody, Scott with Kilimini's Painting and Gaming, and we are back now for episode 2 of the Big Game Hunt, right? That's what it's called? Well, actually it's Big Game Hunting. So welcome back. Hopefully you're enjoying the series. Please make sure you comment if you can. Let me know if I make any mistakes. I did notice in the last episode that when Samson moved in, he basically searched, and then I stopped using the rest of his actions. So, what I'm actually going to do, what I would have done, was attempted to open the trapdoor. So, if he has two actions remaining, we're just going to roll him, see if we can get that door open. That's a 2 and a 3. So, he would have failed. So, didn't matter, right? Other than just adding a little bit more noise. Which this room is already the noisiest anyhow, so not a big deal. So let's go ahead and remove those noise tokens. And we shall move the first player token over. And yeah, let's get started up now. Just a quick state of the board. We've got the Necromancer up north with a runner and a fatty. Another runner working his way down toward us. We eliminated just about everything down here, but then the Abomination showed up. Say hi, Mr. Abomination. Ho, ho. I'm coming to kick your ass. yeah, it's been a long day. I have those quite frequently. In the right eastern spawn, we have one fatty. So we're in a pretty good state. We got everybody grouped up over here in the southwest corner. And we're going to search our little butts off. Remember, we do have the dragon bile and also the torch to deal with this abomination. So normally we'd be searching our butt off anyway in fear. Now we're just like, okay, cool, we got what we need, but we do want to gear up in preparation for the onslaught, right? And what I do want to do, just as a tactics note, is this large building up here. I really want to open this in, if I can, in the blue phase. So the best way to do that is to figure out how far the abomination. He's 1, 2. If I open this turn, then they could go 1, 2, and they could all be in the same square. That's really splitting hairs, though. Don't think I'm going to rush it like that. So we'll see if we get to this in the blue or not. So let's go ahead and start this off. Remember, poor old Samson couldn't open that trap door. But he's going to start off with a search spell. He's going to start off by searching the room. So he finds a shield. This is actually pretty good for Samson, because Samson has the shield ability that he can put on his body instead of being forced to hold it. So that'll allow us to keep our current inventory and drop that shield in there. Also, because he has Ironhide, the blue skill, I believe that shield drops his Ironhide ability now to a 4 or greater. Or I can use the shield as a reroll on the 5+, right? So we'll have to figure out how we're going to do that should we encounter that situation. Now we're going to try to remember Samson still has 2 activations left. He's still in the blue zone, blue threat level. Can only search one per turn. So definitely we're going to go ahead and try to open this door. So let's see if we get any luck. There we go, a 6, a nice shiny 6. Been a while since I've seen one of those. Last episode it was all 1s and 2s, man. I'm telling you, it was rough. So, with the second activation, he noisily batters down this trapdoor and opens it up. And that'll leave him one more remaining. I could have him... Let's see, but he's got a fatty killer, so I'm not going to do that. He is just going to pretty much stay put. Yep. And actually, I paused there for a second because I realized that the last game... I gave Nelly leather armor. I don't think she searched at all, did she? I think that might have been left over from the game before. Wow, that's a bummer. I may actually have to review the video on that because it's kind of a big deal. Yeah, she never got around to searching because remember, I gave her this the quick move to come down here and kick some butt. So look at that. See, and I say I don't have her memory, but... So we're going to basically stick that in the bottom of the pile, near the bottom. All right. Okay, so Samson's turn's done. And now Nelly is stuck down here with the Abomination. So this is good for her because she does have a free move action. So what she can do is then move away for one, and then she'll expend that free action as part of the cost of the two actions to move away, right? So now she'll have two more actions remaining. So she will go ahead and... what does she have? A short sword. She will go ahead and move one and then two as such. Not sure how I feel about that, but yeah. Okay, so that's Nelly's turn done. Sorry about that. I end up with these analysis paralysis moments because actually I realized it's Samson. I wasted his action, and I could have had him move up in preparation and knock out this fatty, but I didn't do it. So that's part of solo mode. You're going to make mistakes like that, and hey, that's how it goes. When you have a brain like mine, I mean, mistakes happen. And honestly, if you're playing with two different players, you're not going to make every single activation count at 100% efficiency, unless you're a friend of mine. His name's Scott Hill. He does that all the time. He's a very smart guy. So, next is Anne. Okay, so Anne's over here in the room. She's in the green. She'll start off with a search action. She finds salted meat. Yay, salted meat. So anyhow, she can discard that at a later date to give her one experience point. It's not going to be right now. So what's she going to do now? She's got two remaining actions. She does have the torch. So, honestly though, I want her to search. Ooh, actually I take that back. She has the torch. So I made a mistake. She gets to pull two search cards with that torch. So she got that and also a shield. So that's handy. However, she can't really use it. So since... what are we going to do? What are we going to do? Got to keep that torch out at the ready. So for now, she's going to place that off into her inventory, into her backpack. And yeah. So that was her first action. And I'm wondering, she'll have two more. Okay, so she's going to enter the trap door in the vault, which will bring her all the way up here as a move action for her second action. And then with her third and final action, she's going to go ahead and pick up the vault artifact, which is the Orcish crossbow, which is a pretty good weapon. I probably won't keep her with it. This axe is both a melee weapon and a ranged weapon as well. And most notably, it does a 2 damage. So we can use it as a fatty killer, right? So she's going to probably put that in her backpack as well. So she's found a couple of really good items there. A shield and an Orcish crossbow. That's quite a good turn for her. So let's see. Team B is all done now. So we'll head over to Team A. Let's see what these guys can do. Now, we can't play past the torch because Anne took off over into the vault. So, we'll start off with Clovis. Clovis in blue. He'll search, and he finds a mana blast. Okay, so Clovis finds this with his first search action. Then he's going to spend an action to do an inventory transfer with Baldrick, who is right here in the same zone. He's going to go ahead and give that over to Baldrick, and Baldrick's going to say thank you very much, but he's still going to put that in his backpack and maybe dual wield that at a later time. Because I tell you what, Baldrick is going to give the speed scroll. He's going to trade him, and then he'll ready that mana blast. So now he can be dual wielding. That'll allow him a 2 dice roll when he attacks, hitting on 4s. So that'll be much better. So Baldrick's, that's Clovis with the second action. And his third action, he's just going to stay put, right? He'll waste that action. So now we head over to Silas. And Silas is one zone away from the abomination. He's got to put some space between him and that abom. He's a little far. So I think 1, 2, 3, and then he won't be able to search till next turn. And then 1, 2, he can return. Yeah, so he goes 1, 2, and then he'll move in for 3 with the hopes of searching the next turn. And that'll be Silas. And now Baldrick is the last player to go in Team A here. Mr. Baldrick will start with a search. And he finds a longbow. So this may come in handy. As this is a fairly long-range weapon. It goes up to 3 zones. See if you can get that in zoom. Okay, yeah, 1 to 3 range. One dice attack hitting on 3s. So this actually could be pretty handy. So that's what Baldrick found. He'll go ahead and put that in his backpack. And then I believe he's going to do an inventory transfer with Silas. So he'll give Silas the longbow, since Baldrick already has a magical range, right? So Silas will happily take that longbow. And yeah, so Baldrick has one more action remaining. And geez, he's going to stay put too. So that's it for the survivor turn. We'll head off into the zombie phase now. There's no attacks that are legal to happen. So we'll head directly into the movement phase for the zombies. The abomination will move up for 1. This fatty here moves over. Then we got these guys up here. So let's move the runner first. 1, 2, super speedy. And here comes the necromancer, looking to try to escape at the nearest spawn, which is down south. And then the runner goes 1, and then 2. So what that looks like is 2 runners ensued by the necromancer and the fatty. So interesting. Let's see what happens now when we spawn them up. So we'll start with the south, and we get a double spawn. So nothing gets spawned there. Instead, we draw 2 cards for the eastern spawn. So we get 1 walker and nothing in the blue phase, which would normally be an extra walker activation, but it's nothing in the blue phase. So we'll put 1 walker at that spot and call that done. And now we still have 2 more spawns up here. So first we'll do the red one. We get, an abomination in the blue phase. Look at that. So it's a good thing we move far away from Mr. Big Guy here, because he's moving 1 further. Yikes. So that's looking ugly. We might actually have to throw down some Dragon Ball pretty quick. Maybe even... yeah. Okay. So we have 1 more spawn point left, and that is this temporary necro spawn. And we draw a no one around. So remember, that does happen in the blue phase. You get a lot of empty draws, which is part of that initial buildup of the threat level. So that works out to our advantage. Of course, we don't really have anybody in the north that's really in any threat, but we don't want that to accumulate too much. So, remove any noise tokens. We only got 1 here. And we will transfer Scully. Oops. Bring him over here. And look to move our Team A, right? So let's think about this now. Do I want to... it's much better to wait until the abomination moves. You know what? No, forget that. I'm gonna press the attack. Because what I've had happen in the past is if you try to wait to him to get to you, he might do a double move like he just did. And then everybody will be stuck with the abomination. You have to spend all your movement to try to escape from him. And then it makes the logistics of throwing down the Dragon Ball very nasty. So I would recommend that as soon as they get, a zone or 2 away, you definitely want to eliminate that threat. So I think that's what we'll do, and we'll, let's see, does that take an action? I believe it does. Let me get my glasses on here. Zoom in. Spend an action, discard Dragon Ball from hand. Yes. Okay. So that'll actually take Clovis too, because, interesting. So that's going to be expensive for Mr. Clovis. So Mr. Clovis will move one. Then he's going to put the Dragon Ball in hand. Like such. With a second action. And for his third action, he's going to drop it at range 1, like the card states. Right here, throws a Dragon Ball right at the Abomination's feet. And that'll be the end of Clovis's activation. And we can actually discard this. Now, which is an interesting note, because once you do that, I think that means now you're kind of weaponless. Now you have to spend another action to fill it. And you know, my inner rules lawyer is telling me that that's incorrect. And then I think that, you know, once you discard and you spend an action, I think you're allowed to fill it. So that's how I'm going to play that. And any rules lawyers out there, if I'm wrong, please feel free to drop me a note in the comments. And we'll address that issue. But I think that's right. I remember reading something about that. So Clovis is done. Still working on Team A here. We got the Dragon Ball down. Team B, which is Nelly, or Anne, she has the torch. So, unfortunately, Anne is way... Ooh, did I miscalculate that? One. Ooh, I did. One, two. No, she'll be able to pull it off. She will be able to pull it off, thankfully. Okay. Woo, starting to get worried there that we were going to have to try some tomfoolery here. Okay, so now that concern is done, Silas in red. We got this threat of a runner, just to the north. He may be hard to see because of the gray. He's going to search anyway. He's going to spend an action to search, and he finds a fireball spell. So that's pretty good because it does, it's a three dice attack hitting on fours. So I like that. We'll go ahead and give that. He'll drop that off into his backpack. And that was one action. So then he will go ahead and move one space to the north for his second activation. Second action. And then he will go ahead and he will shoot off his short bow. One dice attack, hitting on a two or greater. He gets a six. So definitely enough to take him down. We'll give Silas another XP. It bumps him up to three. And that would be Silas's turn done. So now Baldrick will be the last member of this team to go. Baldrick will follow suit and start with a search. So he finds a dagger, which isn't going to do him a whole lot of good. So for now, he will place it there. And I could take a look and see who that could really help. I could either give it to Samson, or I could move and then give that to Clovis. Clovis already gets a die in melee. I think what's going to happen is Baldur's going to go ahead and give that dagger. He's going to spend a second action and give it over here to Samson. Samson's going to go ahead and accept that gratefully. He's going to drop his invisibility spell once I get it in the damn slot. Thank you. And drop his dagger down. So what that's going to do is give Samson a two-dice attack now when he uses his hammer. So that's going to come in handy. So that's Baldrick's second action. And for his third action, I think he'll go ahead and join the party outside in the alley. Okay? So let's move over to Team B. And let's go ahead and get this party started. I think we'll start with Anne. And let's go ahead and blow up some Abomination, right? Let's get some. So Anne's way up here in the vault. Remember, she picked up the special vault weapon. So with one action, she can crawl through the trapdoor and end back up in this room for one. Then she can move forward for two. And then with her last remaining action, she can go ahead and take her torch. And as it says, spend an action, discard the torch from hand, and select a Dragon Battle token at range 0 to 1 to resolve a dragon fire. So basically, light it on fire, right? So that's what she'll do. She'll go ahead and discard it with her third action. And that is going to blow up and incinerate the boss, right? It's going to kill the abomination. So, and the dragon token is now gone. Dragon Battle token. So we'll put that off to the side. Put him away. And that's going to give Anne 5 experience points. So that's actually pretty good because now it's going to put her right at 6. So we're still managing our team in the blue phase. So even through all of this little bit of resistance, we're still positioned, and we position ourselves to, I wanted to say poised. We are poised in position to open up this really large room, a really large building with multiple rooms in the blue zone, which will behoove us because, what do we got there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There's 9 rooms in there. So when we open a door, all hell's going to break loose, right? And we got to be prepared to be able to take it. So I think we're doing all right there so far. So Anne's turn is done. She saved the day with her torch. And Nelly, let's go ahead. Well, actually, let's do Samson next. Samson, I want to put him in position to attempt to get this fatty. And I don't want to run too far from the group, but I do want to get near that door. So, heck with it. He's going to go ahead and search once. Ooh, he finds a greatsword. Nice. This is a 5 dice attack per action, hitting on 5s. So, not the most accurate weapon. If I use it in conjunction with that dagger, he'll have 6 dice. So, nice. Very nice. But for right now, he's got to keep that hammer equipped. So he's going to put that off in his backpack. And another thing to note, too, is that if you look at Samson, when he gets to the orange, which isn't too far away, he's going to get +1 to die roll in melee. So that's going to turn that greatsword into a 4-plus hitting machine, right? Which is 50% odds. I'll take that every day of the week, unless I'm rolling like I did in the last gameplay, right? So Samson did a search for one action, and then he's going to go ahead and move up and then over for his last remaining action. And he is done. And now old Nelly is the last one left. She can't do anything to that fatty that's staring her down. Boy, you know, I really feel like it's time. And it would break my golden rule to have her open that door because she can't really react. Of course she can, because she's got that free movement action. You know, but what happens if... wow. Well, we've already hit a blue abomination. We hit 2 of them, so what are the odds that we're going to get another one, right? So before we hit into yellow, I guess it would make sense to do it now. Hell with it. Let's do it. Let's go for it. So the first thing Nelly's going to do, she's going to try to swing on this door, okay? She opens the door on a 4 or greater, and we get a 5. So it's in the cards. We're going to open this door. So there we go. One action. And we'll put a noise token down. And, yeah. So let's go ahead and spawn up this building. I'm going to start here and then work my way around. So in that first room, we're going to get nothing in the blue zone. I like that. And then right here, we're going to get, one runner. Okay, well, it could be worse. Put a runner there. The room off to the right, we get nothing. What's up with my focus? Okay. So over here, we get a double spawn. Okay. So that means that we skip here, and then in the next room, we do 2 cards. So for there, we get an upside down card. which is two walkers, and a necromancer. So let's put the two walkers down. We'll talk about the necro card. So two walkers here. And now since we've got a necro card, it tells you on the card that if there's a necromancer already on the board, well, actually, let's just read it. Okay. Spawn a necromancer with its necromancer spawn zone. Of course, we've already done that, so we can't do it again. So he gets a free activation. All necromancers already on the board gain an extra activation. So that extra text, I believe, is there when you have more than one necromancer in your spawn pile, right? So let's give him an extra activation. So he moves one step closer, which is fine. We're really not sweating it. Because of the layout of this board, everybody's like in one, you know, one constant road, really. So you'll find on other boards that necromancer can be a bit of a bear, right? So anyhow, let's get back to what we were doing here. Now we got a spawn for this point here, and we get a double spawn. So that means we skip there, and then right here we'll do two. So we get a walker and another double spawn. Okay, so this is where it gets tricky a little bit. So we put a walker here, and then we now double spawn the next spot. We draw two more cards, and we get a fatty and another fatty. Okay, so that the net result is that the next spawn point to the left of that objective gets two fatties. Okay, one more room to go. So we draw the card, and we get one runner. Okay, nice. Let's clean her up. All right, so let's take a look at this. What we got going on. We got the runner in the first room that we open the door. Really a light spawn with all those double spawns, and that's the advantage of doing it in the blue phase. Plus, when you pull those double spawns by themselves, you get to skip that one area. So the two fatties is kind of ugly, but we'll handle them. So really, boy, we this game always does it to me. It makes me feel like, oh, I got everything under control, and then all hell breaks loose. So anyhow, back to Nelly. We're going to finish off the survivor turn. Now Nelly has two actions remaining. Oh boy, she really wants to charge in there and just take out that runner, but she's got a free move action that would give her two swings at it. She doesn't really have any support. She just has a regular short sword. And if I risk all of that and then she fails, well, he's going to double hit her, right? And that is ugly. Three hits and you're out. So that is not a risk I'm willing to take with Nelly. I kind of favor the barmaid. So she is going to tactically retreat. Yes. She's going to move back one, and she will join Samson. And, yeah, they'll talk about the day and killing abominations and the threats that lie ahead. Yeah, and so I think that's where we're gonna cut this one off. I'm trying to keep these around 30 minutes. When we come back, next episode, we'll fire off the zombie phase and see what that's going to entail. But right now, we got things pretty well under control. I think what's going to happen is some of the other quests that I do, I'm entertaining the idea of doing a little bit of fast forwarding, you know, 2, 3, 4 times speed, since there's a lot of just drawing equipment and gearing up in that blue phase, and then just basically show you the yellow, the orange, and the red all in maybe one long video. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. It makes it a very, very long video, so we shall see. Hey, if drop some comments, let me know. I mean, I'm asking you, the community. So here's the point in the video where, hey, make sure you like, you comment, drop me some comments, let me interact with you guys, let me know how you're, if you're digging it, if you hate it, what the deal is. If I made a rules mistake, I'm sure I have. I'm bound to make a mistake. Till next time, Killaminis. Peace out.